Hello, we are the SpaceX fans and welcome to the SpaceX Show, the place where you can stay up to date with everything SpaceX. On Monday, SpaceX successfully launched their 34th Falcon mission of the year with the launch of NROL 69.
One, missions, engine full power, go NROL 69, go Falcon, go SpaceX.
The boost which launched this mission, B-1092, then landed successfully for the second time on the landing pad at landing zone 1.
Impact shutdown.
A couple of days later on Wednesday, SpaceX successfully launched their 35th Falcon mission of the year with the launch of Starlink 11-7.
1, ignition, engines full power, and liftoff. Go Falcon, go Starlink.
The boost which launched this mission, B-1063, then landed successfully for the 24th time on the drone ship Of Course I Still Love You.
Stage 2, terminal guidance. Stage 1, landing leg deploy. Stage 1, landing confirmed.
Coming up later today and going into the week, we should see a bunch of missions launch. The first of these, the Starlink 680 mission, is currently scheduled for today, Sunday 30th at 8:25pm UTC or 4:25pm EDT. Then tomorrow, we should see a crewed Dragon mission launch to a polar orbit. The Fram-2 mission is currently scheduled for Tuesday, April 1st at 2:46am UTC or tomorrow, Monday 31st at 10:46pm EDT. The following day, we should see a Starlink mission launch. The Starlink 11-13 mission is currently scheduled for Wednesday 2nd at 12:39am UTC or Tuesday 1st at 8:39pm EDT. A couple of days later and we should see another Starlink mission launch. The Starlink 11-11 mission is currently scheduled for Friday 4th at 11:42pm UTC or 7:42pm EDT. Then a couple more days later and we should see yet another Starlink mission launch. The Starlink 672 mission is currently scheduled for Sunday 6th at 3:40am UTC or Saturday 5th at 11:40pm EDT. Heading to Boca Chica, work continues on the orbital Pad B launch site. The gantry for the Pad B launch site is continuing as well. Work has also been continuing on the Pad B orbital launch mount. This power bunker was recently delivered to the launch site. More forms were seen going up for the wall around the launch site tank farm. Here's a look at the progress on the scrapping operations of the high bay. There are some new houses being constructed at Starbase. NASA's Launch Services Program posted some information about Starship. They said, welcome to the LSP fleet Starship. SpaceX's Starship rocket has been added to our NASA Launch Services 2 contract as part of the annual on-ramp process which allows providers to introduce launch services not currently on contract. It looks, based on what people are saying, that SpaceX may refly a Super Heavy booster for the first time on Starship Flight 9. However, according to this post, they will not try and catch it for a second time. It says, SpaceX is reportedly planning not to catch booster 14-1 on Starship Flight 9. The booster will perform a water landing in the Gulf of America. Booster 14 previously flew on Flight 7, making Flight 9 its second mission and the first time a booster is being reused. Here's a view of Starship 38's nose cone being worked on in Star Factory. Booster 16 was recently rolled back from Massey's test site. To finish up the video today, we'll take a little look at the Cameron County website where SpaceX have some possible closures. The possible closures are for Thursday, April 3rd and Friday, April 4th. As always, I have to say thanks to Cesar Garcia and Mary, otherwise known as Boca Chica Gal, for being out there filming the Starbase content. Also, thanks to the NASA spaceflight team working behind the scenes on their videos, live streams and other space content. That's it for this episode of the SpaceX Show. I hope you enjoyed the video. If you did, make sure to hit the like button and leave a comment down below. If you want to stay updated with SpaceX info, make sure to subscribe and press the bell icon to get notified when I upload. Thanks for watching and have a great day.